Today we shall reflect on the theme trusting in the Lord. Sometimes we see that it is very difficult to place our faith and our trust in the Lord. Sometimes when there are troubles, when there are various things which do not go according to how we want them to go, it is very difficult for us to find the plan of God in all that. Even though we may know that everything happens for the good, but at that moment it becomes really difficult to comprehend and put everything together. And these are exactly moments wherein we need to put our faith and trust in Jesus, and we need to believe in Him. In a certain way, we need to place our entire selves in His hands, because if we believe and trust in Him, everything is possible. A glance at the first reading of today tells us how Isaiah tells the people that the things of the past shall not be remembered. There will be happiness and rejoicing. Similarly, we see that when we go for confession, that when we pray to the Lord is not interested in what we have done in the past, but He is more interested in what we want to do, in how we plan to go about our day and in the future. And similarly, Isaiah prophesied that God would come not only to restore His people, but He would also come to create a new heaven and a new earth. Every day, God gives us new opportunities to make a difference in our lives and also in the lives of others. And it is up to us whether we want to take this opportunity, whether we want to do something different in our lives as well as in the lives of others. A glance at today's gospel passage reveals the second miracle that Jesus performed in Cana. We see that these miracles that Jesus performed were signs that manifested the kingdom of power and glory. We see that a high-ranking official decided to seek Jesus out for an extraordinary favor. It could have been quite surprising, because this man, who was an official, probably was very popular and had a lot of power. And probably he could have taken his son to some great doctors in his own place. But when he heard that Jesus was coming this way, he decided to go meet Jesus and ask for a favor. And probably we could imagine, if such an incident had to happen in today's world, the headlines on various forms of media would be as follows. High-ranking official leaves capital in search of a miracle cure from a small town carpenter. Yes, indeed, it must have taken great courage from the part of the official in order to travel that distance and meet Jesus. Apart from the travel, he would also have to deal with a lot of ridicule that his friends and others would have to say. Probably they may have said to him, "Why are you going to this man when you have so many good physicians at your place?" But here we see that the man had faith and trust in Jesus. And when Jesus recognized that the man had this faith and trust in him, he told him and reassured him that his son would be well. Now probably it may not have been easy for this man to go home empty-handed. As we know, he would have had some expectations when he came to meet Jesus. He would have probably planned how he would take Jesus back to his place, what welcome he would have given him at his hometown, etc. But when Jesus told him to go, "Your son will be well," probably all his plans would have crumbled. But at the same time, he believed in Jesus. And that is what was really important. He believed, and his faith cured his son. And in this way, it also shows us that healings and kindness and the love of Jesus that he has for our broken world. In a very special way, today let us pray for this grace, that we may be able to place our trust and hope in the Lord, even in times where everything seems lost.